Hi, this is Deborah Torres, author of Amish Fiction, and in this video, you're going to learn about Beverly Lewis's new book, The Stone Wall. And if you watch to the end of this video, you're going to find out how you can get your own 30-page Amish and Mennonite cookbook absolutely free when you sign up for my author newsletter. Here I am in the Pacific Northwest visiting family, and I was looking for a stone wall. I know in Beverly Lewis's book, the stone walls run through the rolling parts, farmlands of Pennsylvania. So I knew that in the Pacific Northwest, maybe it'd be a little difficult. I actually did a little research on it to see if there were any established stone walls in this area, and found out that there were a lot of landscapers who wanted to put a stone wall in my yard, but nothing historic that I could find. So I was walking in a resort space and found this stone wall. It's definitely not what Beverly Lewis is talking about in her books, but it is super cool, and I'm so glad to be able to do a little video right in front of it. If you've read The Stone Wall yet, you know that it plays a really important part of Beverly Lewis's book. But anyway, super cool. So we're going to talk a little bit first about Beverly Lewis. This is her latest book, and I know a lot of you are super fans of Beverly's, as well as I am. But this one, I actually attended her book launch. It was on Facebook, and it was really cool because there was just a lot of fun and games going on. Beverly Lewis was commenting back and forth, as well as I think her publicist. But she had a lot of fun games like, you know, would you rather go to certain places in Lancaster County where her character visits? And they actually had her publicist read a little snippet, I think, of one of her chapters. And what was really cool is they had a picture of her models for her front cover, and they were standing on opposite sides of the stone wall, I think in front of a green screen. So anyway, super cool to be able to kind of be part of the book before reading the book. But I went ahead and bought it, and one of the really cool things about this book is that it's time split fiction. Now, I didn't know anything about time split fiction, and I'm still kind of new to it, and I'm thinking I actually want to write a little bit of this kind of subgenre. But anyway, time split fiction is where you have, it's not like where someone goes back in time, but it's where you have two characters, one in present time, or one in a certain amount of present time, and one in past time. And I actually went and got a book on time split fiction, and I'm reading it called A Split in Time, but it talks about how to write time split fiction. So anyway, I wondered if Beverly had read this book or learned a little bit about time split fiction when she wrote this. But anyway, certainly added a level of intrigue to the book. Loved that part. Again, I didn't even know what it was called, but when I read this book, I was like, oh, that's what she was doing. So anyway, back to the story. The story, The Stone Wall, is a sweet story. It's about a girl named Anna Beachy. I think she's in her early 20s. And she's gone through a breakup and is having a difficult time just really knowing where her place is in life. So she's struggling with that. She's actually among the Beachy Amish. And I didn't know a lot about the Beachy Amish. I had heard about them, didn't know a lot about them. But actually, the Beachy Amish, I've got it in here in my notes, they broke away from the old order Amish in the 1927. And they allow modern conveniences, which is kind of interesting to read a book about an Amish young lady and have her driving a car, having her access her GPS, having her access apps and things like that. But she's dressed in, in the Amish dresses, and you know, things are very simple for her, but other than modern conveniences. So that was really cool to kind of get that level of what it meant to be a different kind of Amish person. But Anna needs a change in her life, and she ends up working. She contacts her mother's cousin who lives in Lancaster County in Strasburg. And there's a job opening for her at a local tourism place, and they need people to come and give people custom tours, which I thought that was pretty cool because, you know, you could kind of like go along and just kind of see where you're supposed to go. But this is custom tours where these people would say, I want to see a horse farm. I want to go to a bakery. I want to see a bookshop. I want to do this. And then she would take them in her car, I guess, or maybe there'd be a drive. I think they would drive and she would go along. And it would go to all those places, be escorted by her. So they get to see a lot of the cool things. But the best thing, one of the best things about this book is that the way Beverly does it is she, because the girl's a tour guide, we learn, so, as readers, learn so much about the area. just from her visiting these places and the people going along with her. So anyway, love that part. If you are planning on visiting Lancaster County, you might want to read this book first to learn about all the cool places you might want to go to, because I want to go to them sometime as well. One of the big things that struck me different about this book, and like I said before, when I was learning what the Beachy Amish, who they were, is Beachy Amish is literally different than Old Order in some senses. There were cases where Anna was interested in some young men and they weren't even allowed to, it wasn't even looked upon, favored upon to date between Old Order Amish and Beachy Amish, which I thought that was pretty interesting. Anyway, another thing that's really brought into this book is the cards. Beverly Lewis and her sister, they have a card company called Amish Cheer. And I have a video that I'll put at the end of this video for you to watch. But anyway, they're specialty cards, keepsake cards, cheer up cards. And Beverly weaves those books into her novel. The lady Sadie, who Anna is staying with, makes cheer up cards, and it's the same kind of thing. So I love how Beverly weaved that into the book, because I knew about those cards already, so it was kind of cool. But anyway, the plot of the story, Anna's grandmother Eliza is dealing with some memory loss, and she's an elderly woman, and she is living with Anna's sister, but she's having difficulty remembering things, and so they're kind of all mourning that part of their grandmother. But their grandmother actually had spent time in the same place in Strasbourg where Anna is going to. And so Anna spends a little bit of time with her grandmother, again, having memory loss. And her grandmother says something sort of intriguing. She says, Grandma, I'm going to Strasbourg, you know, where you had spent some time. And she says something about a stone wall, like out of nowhere. And Anna is like, what does that even mean, a stone wall? Meet me at the stone wall, or meet me by the light of the moon. And later on, she talks about a stone wall. So throughout this whole time when Anna is in Strasbourg, she's wondering what the mystery of the stone wall is. Again, her grandmother doesn't speak a whole lot of things that are things that she understands. So when she said that, it was like, oh, what is this? I want to find out more about a stone wall. So she's always got that mystery, and that's kind of the mystery that weaves in between. And so the time slip part of this book is when Beverly starts talking about Eliza's life. And Eliza, it was a certain number of years ago in history when Eliza was a young girl, 16, when she was in Strasbourg taking care of an elderly aunt. She didn't want to be there. Parents sent her to be there. And she falls in love with an Old Order Amish man. Now, Eliza is Beachy Amish, just like Anna, but she falls in love with the man. And so they know that they can't like express their love in front of people. So they have a stone wall in between, and there's a special stone where they hide special notes to each other in. So that's really cool. So anyway, the story goes in and out. It comes back with Anna, and then it goes back with Eliza. Anna has two love interests in the book. There's a Mennonite man who she's possibly going to date. And then there's a man who owns a horse farm for disabled children. And she's very interested in him as well. But he is Old Order Amish. And remember, the Old Order Amish, from this book anyway, it doesn't look favorably upon them to date Beachy Amish. So there's always that pressure on her mind that her parents are going to be really mad and not going to accept her. So anyway, we keep going back in time to Eliza's life and then Anna's life. And, she carves out the time split for you. The thing that always is kind of going on between the two of them is Anna's falling for an Old Order Amish man, just the way her grandmother Eliza did. And again, the stone wall plays a big part. I don't want to tell you the whole story. I do want to tell you that I really enjoyed this one. I loved going back in time and then coming back to the present day and then going back in time. For me, that adds just a whole layer of intrigue to a story, a whole layer of depth. So I really encourage you to read it. I do like to go back sometimes and say, you know, what I didn't like about a book, just because I like to be honest as a reviewer. Sometimes books in this have like a pace that gets kind of slow, and it's like, oh, is there ever anything going to happen? And I really didn't feel like this in this book, and I think it was the time slip. It was because, you know, Anna was going here, and then Beverly, and then Eliza had this going on, and it was exciting how she meshed it together. Super sweet ending. So really, really recommend it. Let me just see if there's anything else I wanted to say. Also loved, you know, going to the places in Lancaster County with Anna. She had a couple things. She had a bird in hand bake shop, log cabin quilt shop, and fabrics, Lap Valley Farms ice cream. I mean, who wouldn't want to go to those places? So anyway, super enjoyed Beverly's book, highly recommend it. Last thing is, I guess that's all I need to say, but if you haven't yet subscribed to my YouTube channel, please do it now in the link below. And also, if you want to get your hands on my free 30-page Amish and Mennonite cookbook with authentic recipes, you want to subscribe below as well. And when you subscribe, you'll subscribe to my author newsletter. You'll get that free in your inbox. So anyway, this is Deborah Torres again, author of Amish Fiction. Next book that I'm going to be reviewing is When Hearts Break by Jerry Ecker. Super, super hard, but good read as well. So anyway, I'm so excited you're here with me in the Pacific Northwest, and we'll see you on the next Amish book review.